Namaste. I'm Sarita Raghuvanshi, and today we are in conversation with a man who's defined every notion about South Indian cinema on national level and every single notion about Indian cinema on a global level. He's proved to the world that every fragment of imagination can be used to tell stories wonderfully in the world of cinema. And he's at it again with his next venture. We are in conversation with none other than the phenomenal Prabhas. So after the unprecedented success of Bahubali, the entire industry has been watching every single move that you've made. With that tremendous amount of pressure, how do you zero down on a film like Zaho?
We didn't actually plan to make such a big film. But you know, we had time for planning after Bahubali 1, so there's a lot of planning and pre-production happening, and the producers, they wanted a quality film, and Sujit was designing very well. So everybody got excited and we started, and after Bahubali it's not easy to do just a normal action film.
Exactly.
So we planned, and once after the plan, when it started, you know, it just became bigger and bigger.
So since you mentioned Sujit, I want to ask you, Sujit is just one film old and he's only 28, and he dealt with a cast and crew that is far more experienced than him on this entire set. How did he manage to keep everything under control?
The first, when I told about the big technicians, like, I was working with Sabu Sir then in part one, so I said, please meet him because he can give the look what you're thinking about. So he was very worried to meet Sabu Sir. Then he went to meet some Bollywood actors, he was like stressed because he just did one Telugu film. And then Srikar sir, all the biggest of the country we got, and slowly it took time for him, four five months to plan and to do a pan-Indian film. Also, he's very confident, but it took time for him to meet artists and to convince them and all. And after a few months, I think he became very confident, and he's done one of the biggest films.
So Zaho is now 4 days away from its release, and it is releasing in over 10,000 screens across the world.
I didn't know that, but yeah.
So yeah, more than that actually.
Yeah, okay.
So, and it is one of the biggest releases that India has ever seen. So does that make you anxious?
Yes.
If yes, then how do you stay calm and so composed throughout?
Jesus, I'm an actor, so I think I'm acting. I'm really stressed, and for my friends and for me and for after Bahubali fans, audience, and Suji, technicians, everybody who worked. So we are all, a lot of people are stressed, especially the director, me, and the producers. But it's time now. I think another 4 or 5 days. Hope everything sounds good after that.
So this is your first Hindi film, and things work differently when you do a Hindi film, right? And you've been doing a lot of promotions. I want to ask you, have you gotten used to the media?
Yeah, I think I'm much comfortable now than when I came for Bahubali 1. 2 was better, but still I'm not much of a talking and social person. So it was not. It was better of part 2, but now I think I'm much more comfortable, I think.
Okay.
So my friends were asking, like, you're talking more than Shraddha nowadays.
So that's become like a benchmark.
Yeah, I don't know, but yeah, now I'm very comfortable.
Okay, so you've just mentioned that you are a person who's not very talkative and a bit shy, and we see the character that you're playing, the undercover cop that you're playing, is larger than life. So can you tell us what is your process that you follow to get into the skin of a character which is totally different from the real Prabhas?
So it depends upon the character, the way it's designed. Sujit and me, we had some workshops, and he wanted me to do something like this, and I told, can I do this? And after the shoot started, slowly we improvised a little more, and I think, yeah. It was a process. It's not like Bahubali is like a very deep character, Ramananda Bahubali. It's not like that. It's a present film, so yeah. It was interesting the way he designed, I think.
Okay, so the design works? So we also know that in South India, Bollywood actresses come and become a part of these major commercial films, and majorly to add a glamour factor. But here we are seeing Shraddha Kapoor playing a full action-packed role. So do you think that Sahu is a trendsetter and changing the game for actresses in South India?
They're like not only South, North, or wherever. Sometimes heroines doesn't have much role, but yeah, in Sahu it has a very important character. It's not like fixed that all the heroines should have in South very less role. It's not like that. They're very amazing. You saw Bahubali
yeah,
and all.
The characters so it's,
yeah, they're very, very strong. They're stronger than, you know, sometimes the Sivagamani, they're stronger than Bahubali in some of the scenes. It's not like that. But in this film, the Shraddha's is one of the most important characters, I feel. I think the Shraddha's character is helps the film to elevate and change into different dimensions. And it has a very emotional side and love and action. I think I love the Shraddha's role in the film.
One more thing that I want to ask you is that we all know that you are this mega superstar and you have a humongous fan following. But what we also know is that you are this very humble, down-to-earth person. How do you stay so grounded? Is it your upbringing that you give the credit to?
Yeah, maybe it's upbringing, maybe the flops I had before, and maybe looking at these people like Rajmouli, and maybe my mother wants me always be careful this industry, and she never wanted me to be in the industry. So all these things may be the factors. And luckily I have friends which I grew up with, and I'm they're very happy for Bahubali, but for them it's nothing. If I do a little you know who I am, like chill, you're still okay.
So they keep you grounded.
Yeah, they keep me.
It's good to be surrounded people by people like that. Before I move on to the final message for all your fans who absolutely love you, I want to ask you just one thing. Since this is your Hindi movie, I mean this is your first Hindi movie, I'm going to test your Hindi quotient. I'm going to tell you something in Hindi. You just have to identify what is it that I'm talking about. Okay. Lamb dand gol pin dhar pakad pratiyogita. The hint is it's a sport.
Again, say it again.
Lamb dand gol pin dhar pakad pratiyogita.
Kabaddi.
You're very close, but okay, it's one of the biggest sport in the country.
Hockey. God, that is the biggest sport. Oh, cricket. And think about Indian sports.
Okay, right, goal is a ball.
And what was it?
Dharpakad Pratiyogita. So basically, there is a lot of running that's happening. You catch the ball.
Okay.
So that's how
this
cricket
is
described in
old Hindi. Yeah?
No, this is the definition of cricket in Hindi. And the second word for you is Lohpath Gamini. Lohpath Gamini. I will give you a hint. This is one of the most used network of transportation in the country.
Again, once more.
Lohpath Gamini.
Bus. Train.
Close. Yes, that's it.
Okay.
Thank you so much for speaking to us at Daily Hunt. Before I wrap, can I request you to please give a message to all your fans?
August 30th, Sahu is releasing. Please enjoy it. Hope you enjoy it. Have fun. Thank you.
Thank you so much for speaking to us. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you.